Everybody, welcome to Managerial Accounting, Cost, Volume, Profit. We're going to finish up here our composite unit example. So let's go to the Google Sheet. So what we left off with is we had three products, A, B, and C. We're also given a ratio for every 10 units of product A are sold, 6 units of product B are sold, and 4 units of product C are sold. Product A has a sales price of 100, variable cost of 80. That means it must have a contribution margin per unit of 20. Product B has a sales price of 80, variable cost of 40, must means that the contribution margin per unit is 40. Product C has a sales price of 70, variable cost of 25, means the contribution margin per unit is 45. If you follow these little things up here, this is how I'm going through and figuring out the numbers. My ratio is 10 to 6 to 4. I multiply the 20 by 10, I get 200, 40 by 6, 240. 45 by 4, and I get 180. When I add up these three numbers, this is giving me my contribution margin per composite unit. My total fixed costs are 1,116,000. So this means I need to sell 1,800 composite units sold to achieve break even. But does that mean I'm selling of product A? Does that mean I'm just going through and selling 1,800 units of each of these, right? The answer is no, right? And the reason is these are my composite units. And I'm going to call this F, okay? These are my composite units. To figure out how many I need to sell of each, what I'm going to do is I'm going to multiply this by the ratio. So over here, my ratio is 10 to 6 to 4. When I multiply my contribution, my composite units by my ratio, this is going to give me my units sold of each product for break even. Okay, so this is going to be 1,800 times 10 or 18,000. 6 times 1,800, 4 times 1,800. So when I go through and do this, I can't just say, oh, I sold 1,800 units of A. I have to go back through, take the composite units and multiply it back through by the ratio. Now, the favorite thing I always love to go through and do, are these numbers correct? If we've done this problem correctly, right? What I should have at the end of the day is I should have a contribution margin of 1,116,000. Let's see if we can get this to work. So my sales price for, or my sales so I have product A, product B, product C. Okay, my units that I sold of product A are going to be 18,000, product B are 10,008, and product C are 7,200. My sales price per unit is at 100 for product A, 80 for product B, and 70 for product C. So my total is going to be 18,000 times 10, 10,800 times 80. Product C is 7,200 times 70. So my total sales are going to be 1.8, 864, and 504. Okay, now let's look at our variable costs. So our variable costs, again, we're doing a variable costing income statement, my variable cost per unit. So over here, product A, product B, product C. If I sold 18,000 units of product A, I need 18,000 units for variable costs. Same with product B, product C. My variable cost per unit is $80 for product A, $40 for product B, and $25 for product C. When I go through and multiply this through, 18,000 times 80, 10,800 times 40, 7,200 times 25. So my total variable costs are going to be $2,052,000. Okay. So now when I subtract my sales from my variable costs from the other videos we've been watching, that is going to give us our contribution margin. Okay. Or $1,116,000. My fixed costs are going to be $1,116,000. So my net income is going to be zero. So I have officially gone through and I have broken even. So that's how we go through and look at this type of question. If I wanted a faster way to check my work, what could I have done? So the other thing I could do over here is I could say, well, why don't I just look at the contribution margin? What do I mean by that? If I take my contribution margin and I break this down between product A, B, and C, my units being sold are going to be the same. It's 18,000 of A, 10,800 of B, and 7,200 of product C. My contribution margin per unit is going to be over here at 20, 40, and 45. So my total, 18,000 times 20, 10,008 times 40, 7,200 times 45. So my total contribution margin is going to be $1,116,000. So if I'm looking for a faster way to go through and to verify that my work is correct, right? Because the one thing hopefully you've learned from all of these different assignments is to be going through and kind of figuring out, okay, got to plug it in, got to make sure that it works, right? Is the number, is this 1800 composite units? Is that actually correct? Now, the last thing I'm going to share with you is that what if they say, oh, you need to achieve an after-tax profit of whatever the amount is, what you're in, if there's a tax rate, what am I going to do? It's no different than the other problems that we've been going through and looking at. Just treat the after-tax profit, convert it to pre-tax. Then that's going to be added to the fixed cost because that's going to tell you the new contribution margin that you need to achieve. If we look at all of these break-even questions, break-even assumes a net income of zero. All we're doing is we're covering our fixed costs. If we're adding in more costs to be covered, go ahead and add it in because that's going to be the new contribution margin we're going to need to achieve in order to reach that after-tax profit. So I want to thank you for watching these videos here. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. The last afterthought, because I think this is going to be the last video I'm going to make in this series, my last thought that I will be leaving with you is just make sure you're going through and learning this variable costing income statement. You'll find it comes in tremendous help as you're going through and doing these problems. I look forward to seeing you on the next video. If you'd like to see another video, please feel free to request it in the comments below. Have a great day.